If you remember, I recently came up with a list of the best budget tablets you could buy this year. Still, to be completely honest with you guys, every single entry in that list had multiple compromises in one way or the other. However, the new Realme Pad that I have with me right now looks like a pretty well-balanced bundle in the budget category. I have been using it for almost 2 weeks now and I am quite impressed with it. And I really hope that this one gets wider availability too. Currently, it's only available in India where its price starts from 14,000 rupees, whereas I have the 464GB LTE configuration that cost 18,000 rupees. Okay, let me first talk about what I love the most about this tablet. At first glance, it's unquestionably the build quality and design. Despite being a budget tablet, Realme has offered a relatively premium aluminium unibody build with squared off edges, which feels sturdy and strong. Also, the brush design at the back does not attract fingerprints or smudges, while its weight distribution is equally balanced as well. Measuring just 6.9 millimeters thick and weighing only 450 grams, the Realme Pad is also quite thin and lightweight. As a result, holding it with one hand while scrolling through my Facebook feed or when attending my online meetings has been no problem at all. In terms of buttons, they're all located on the edge and have decent tactile feedback. On the right, there's the volume rockers and a hybrid SIM card slot, whereas you'll find the power button on the top. Finally, there's a headphone jack alongside the rounded corners on the bottom left. Now, another thing that's arguably better on the Realme Pad as compared to other budget tablets is its display. Here, you are greeted with a 10.4 inches IPS LCD screen that has a good color balance and does not sacrifice the viewing angle either. This screen is also plenty bright at 360 nits and is therefore perfectly fine for indoor usage. Realme also claims that it can go as low as 2 nits under the night mode. In my experience, I found that this panel can get dimmer than what I am used to seeing on my smartphones. And that's incredible for someone like me who likes to read ebooks at night. However, one thing that I've noticed about this display is that it's relatively on the cooler side and the new Realme Pad OS does not let you calibrate it according to your needs either. So I hope Realme brings a feature to play with the color settings with the next OTA update. Anyway, as expected from a budget tablet, it misses out on HDR and DCI-P3 colors, although it does have Wide One L1 certification, which means that I am able to stream full HD videos on OTT platforms. And with a quad speaker setup backing it all up, watching CDs and listening to songs has been a great experience on the Realme Pad. The audio can grow loud enough to fill a medium-sized room. It offers a nice stereo effect and the lows can get boomy enough to satisfy the bass heads as well. There was also a bit of fuss surrounding the launch of this tablet. Francis Wong, the CMO of Realme India, originally tipped that the Realme Pad would have an AMOLED display. But come the launch day, everyone, including me, was disappointed to find out that this tablet has an IPS panel instead. So my guess is that Realme is maybe working on a Pro variant of the Realme Pad with an AMOLED screen and other upgrades. Now, talking about the Realme Tab's performance, in this aspect too, it performs better than the competition. Here, you get a decent MediaTek Helio G80 chipset, which is much superior to the Snapdragon 429 on the Lenovo Tab M10 or the Helio P22 on the Galaxy A7 Lite. However, if you're coming from a newer mid-range or an even more powerful phone, you will notice app load time or multitasking abilities on the Realme Pad to be slightly slower. Similarly, it does not have that buttery smooth experience I'd hoped for. There's even a hint of jelly scrolling effect here. But then again, at this price, I can't really complain much. This tablet is completely fine for all the basic tasks, multitasking with split screen works well, and it can even run some of the high-end games with ease. Here, PUBG Mobile is playable at smooth graphics and ultra frame rates, and Call of Duty Mobile at medium graphics and high frame rates. You will not notice any frame drops or lags, which is pretty impressive considering none of the other budget tablets at this price range will be able to deliver similar results. Likewise, the battery life on the Realme Pad is also very good. Its 7,100 mAh cell easily lasted nearly 2 days during my rigorous testing. Plus, it also comes with an 18-watt fast charger, which takes around 2 hours and 45 minutes to fully juice up. Okay, with that out of the way, let me talk about the things that are not so good about the Realme Pad. And the first thing that comes to mind is its UI. Although Realme has not included crap bloatware here and instead ships with a near-stock experience, this UI does have a few limitations of its own. For instance, there aren't many customization options or additional features you can play around to utilize such a big screen. So there are a ton of avenues where the Realme UI for tablets can get better in its forthcoming iterations. Likewise, the cameras here are not that great either. Although its 8 megapixel dual camera setup is completely fine for taking images of notes and such, you will instantly notice the lack of details and dynamic range when clicking photos of scenery or buildings. As for the video quality from the front-facing camera, it is adequate for casual Zoom meetings or group chats with pals, whereas the audio from the mic is fine too. Still, I feel like Realme could have offered slightly higher res hardware, which would have certainly made these cameras stand out. But at this point, I realize I'm asking for a lot from a budget tablet. Overall, despite some limitations, the Realme Pad is one hell of a budget tablet. It nails all the basics, including a good display, quad speakers, excellent battery life, and more than capable performance. So yeah, I would definitely recommend it to anyone from students to multimedia freaks who are looking for a reliable budget tablet. So there you have it, guys, our review of the all-new Realme Pad. We are coming up with reviews of other Realme products such as the Realme C25Y and the Realme Band as well. So for that, do not forget to subscribe to our channel and hit that notifications icon. Till then, I am Pratibha Adhikari and I'll see you in my next video.